Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and we will be discussing the joints in the shoulder region. Namely, we will be focused on the acromioclavicular joint and the glenohumeral joint, better known as the shoulder joint. So a quick review regarding bony articulations. The acromioclavicular joint is formed by the articulation of the acromial or lateral end of the clavicle and the acromion of the scapula, and this will form the acromioclavicular joint, which is a plane joint, so slight movements occur here. Conversely, a wide range of movements can occur at the ball and socket glenohumeral joint, which is formed by the socket, which is the glenoid fossa of the scapula, and the ball, which is the head of the humerus. And notice how close these joints are to each other. The AC joint is located just superior to the shoulder joint. Let's discuss accessory structures associated with these joints, starting with the coracoclavicular ligament. And the name of this ligament gives you all the clues regarding where it's located. This will be located between the coracoid process of the scapula and the clavicle, so the coracoid process and then clavicle. So you can see it's a rather robust ligament, shaded in light blue here, so coracoclavicular. And you can see it over here on this image that's not shaded, so the coracoid process is right here. This is the clavicle, and so right here would be the coracoclavicular ligament. This ligament plays a very important role in the integrity and stability of the acromioclavicular joint, so severe shoulder separations often involve damage to this ligament. Here shaded in purple is the coracoacromial ligament, which extends between that coracoid process and the acromion. I actually like it better here on this unshaded image. So here's the coracoid process again, and here is the acromion, and you can really see the expanse of this ligament. And you can see how the ligament, so the coracoacromial ligament, as well as its bony attachment sites, are forming an arch. So the coracoacromial arch will be located right in this region, and this allows for structures that are going to or from the shoulder joint region to travel deep to the coracoacromial arch. This whole shiny opaque region right here is going to be the capsule of the glenohumeral joint. So the joint capsule, that's the reason why we can't see the glenoid fossa and the head of the humerus on these dissections, because the capsule is surrounding and protecting these structures. So this is the capsule. Oops. I often get asked during dissections, what is this ligament here? Why can't I move it? Why can't I see the head of the humerus or say the glenoid fossa? And it's all because you've reached the actual capsule, which can be quite strong in many locations, joint locations. A major player in the shoulder joint region are the rotator cuff tendons, which form the nearly complete cuff of tendon around the shoulder joints, with only a slight inferior deficiency. And these tendons are really the major source of stability to this region. You can follow the muscle bellies of these muscles laterally. So you can see three of them here. This is a rotator cuff muscle, rotator cuff muscle, rotator cuff muscle, and you can follow them laterally, and you can see where it's just becoming opaque and kind of white in this region, and that's where the tendons are. And the same thing here, and you can see, almost see it a little bit better here. You have this one anteriorly placed rotator cuff muscle, and its tendon kind of gets lost right about here-ish, and that's because it becomes intermingled with the joint capsule of the shoulder joint. So you can really see how that tendon is kind of crossing over this region, intermingling with the capsule, and you're really having that strong protection in this region. Lastly, I want to mention the labrum. The labrum is a fibrocartilaginous lip that's located, it circumscribes the glenoid fossa, allowing a slightly better fit between the articulating bones. You really only find labra associated with ball and socket joints. So you have one here with the shoulder joint, you'll have one with the hip joint as well. And this isn't a particularly great image of the labrum. You can see that the joint capsule has been incised here in order to get a slight view into the actual joint. And you can see a bit of the labrum. So this would be right about here, would be the glenoid fossa. And you can see a bit of the labrum right in this region. But again, the labrum kind of traces the borders of the glenoid fossa. And usually if you have a direct view, if you're looking straight at the glenoid fossa, that's typically where you can see the labrum better. Otherwise, if you're looking kind of right here like we are, it's hard to differentiate it between the surrounding joint capsule. All right, excellent. Thank you for your time and attention as I discuss my favorite joint, the shoulder joint. I hope you have a great rest of your day.